Well, howdy, 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 folks. I am happy to be here. Hope you are too. It has been a little bit. Last week, I don't know if you've seen the video I gave you, a vendor shared with us. That vendor is Don Marler. He's in Missouri and has, he didn't really quit vending. He moved on up. He retired as Cater Pro and got this huge monstrosity custom built cart. Hope you saw that. Anyway, let me make sure my stuff is working. It looks like it is. In the meantime, you could be clicking the, you know, thumbs up button or something. I wanted to talk to you today about Bain-Marie's or double boilers, or you could call them steam tables, but not every steam table is the same or alike or can benefit you the same. I filmed a vendor one time in Florida on the coast, on the Gulf Coast, and he had a steam table that he couldn't do much with. It had one burner, so he couldn't have like a cooler area or a hotter area, and so it created problems for him. But that was the least of the problems for some vendors. Some vendors go out and without doing their due diligence or without checking with other vendors. It's why we have Vendors United, is so you can talk to other vendors before making a decision, do some due diligence. Why I have learnhotdogs.com so that you can find out what to do. Hey, Jason. Hey, Chris. Hey, David. Hey, Thomas. Thanks for being here. So you have these options to do before you get started. And I'm not going to go into a rant today. Hey, Stever and John Mack in the house. As far as I have a rant, I need to save it for tomorrow probably when I'm a little cooler headed. Because lately a ton of people, I mean more than ever, are getting into the business because of the COVID deal and people losing their jobs and people are looking elsewhere. And so sales are through the roof on carts, but not just with me, with all manufacturers, but some manufacturers sell a steam table that is more like a Bain-Marie. And what a Bain-Marie is, and I'm going to draw this. Hopefully you can hear me. If you can't hear me good, let me know. I'm fixing to stand up and explain this so you know what you're getting into. And I am also going to provide you a solution. Howdy, Timothy. Love it. Love it. Glad y'all are here. Ken Costa in the house. Thanks for being here, brother. So here's the deal. And here's the negative one, okay? So a Bain-Marie is basically what you would think of as a drop-in steam table. So this is a side view of a steam table that has burners built into it, okay? So you might have one burner, or you might have two, or you might even have three. This is a normal size steam table. It's 20 inches. Hopefully you can see all that. Okay, so it's 12 by 20 roughly, 12 wide, 20 long across. So when you see a steam table that is built in, what it already has is basically a built-in spillage pan, is for lack of better words. It's a built-in spillage pan, which means that there is never direct heat unless you put hot dogs directly into here, which most people can't do because they use either a material in here. It's not made for cooking in here. So, and you're going, Ben, how would you cook in it if you can't cook in it, right? Well, what they expect you to do is put in pans. And the pans sit in here. Some are deeper than others. And they sit in here, and you fill this area down here with water. So you have water down here. And maybe just an inch, maybe half an inch, but you have water in the bottom. The pans sit over the water, and what happens is the heat transfers up to these pans, okay? So let's say you wanted to boil hot dogs in your third size pan or your half size pan. It's absolutely impossible because the way this is set up to boil this water, but not up here. This is steam. It's indirect heat. So remember this, indirect heat, which all vendors use, but we don't want that exclusively. we don't want indirect heat all the time. Because if we, when we get to a job and we set up, a normal cart will have a hole in the cart and you can see the burner. So let's go a top view of a cart, okay? Here's the steam table end. You look down there, you should be able to see two, three burners. Some carts have one. I'd steer clear of those, but two is way better and three is way more good or better. So now you have three burners. So this is a full-size steam table, let's say, or, you know, like a big dog or a cash cow with a double steam table. It's actually two. So what you would do is you'd put a pan here in that steam table, and it's getting direct heat. So if you saw it from the side, here's your pan. I'm going to try to draw a pan. This is inside of this steam table. Here's your pan. You filled it with water. Now you've thrown in some hot dogs, right? They're floating around. And there's a burner right there, and it is directly heating this water in the pan. So it's directly heating that water, creating the boil, which is also creating steam, which is why we call them steam tables. But this is direct heat, and you cannot get direct heat with these. So a vendor messaged me last week, and I haven't gotten to it till today because I'm behind several days on emails and voicemails. But he told me, he goes, what do I do? I already bought this cart, and it has an indirect steam table. How do I boil my dogs or do anything? My solution to this, you may not like, is to cut out this. Cut out the bottom of that. That way this has flames, that's your burners, can heat your pan. So you still put in your pans, you can still boil, okay, like we did here, but you can also still steam. So let's say a normal, and you can look at my video at learnhotdogs.com. You can go to learnhotdogs.com/bonus. Just type in the word bonus. Look at the third, fourth, and fifth video on that page, and you will have a complete walk around of me on the cart with this setup showing all this. Okay. I just don't go into indirect like this, these built in steam tables, which suck. They just don't work. They're great for, you already cooked your food and you're keeping it warm, but a vendor needs to direct heat. He needs to be able to boil. He needs to be able to get hot, and then indirect heat, whether that's in a steam table or just water. Right? Hot water. So he could cut out this section and have direct heat, but he could also have indirect heat. And you may be going, well, how is he going to get indirect heat? So we go back to a steam table, okay, and we drop in a spillage pan, which is the size of the steam table. So we've essentially created this. Or we can drop in a half size one, okay? So we can use this for direct heat. We can use this to put a pan inside of. And now we have water down here, and we're keeping stuff warm right here. And we're boiling here, or direct heat here. So do you see what I'm saying? You got fire here and fire here. But we got water down here to create the direct heat. So the best way to see that in action, I actually show it, is to use learnhotdogs.com. And if somebody's paying attention, post this in the comments. It'll help people find it. /bonus. Just bonus. And it's just some videos I did that will show you on a live cart how to set that up. To have part of the cart direct heat, part of it on steam. Because every vendor does this. All the good vendors do this. It's hard to operate a business this way. So if this was my cart that the gentleman emailed me about, I would cut this bottom out and make it all direct heat, and then I'd create my indirect heat by using spillage pans or false bottom pans. Okay? And you're going, oh my God, what's a false bottom pan? Well, it's explained right here. Okay? But I'm gonna give you the short version. So let's say you have a full-size steam table, 20 inches, okay? 20 inches from here, 20 inches from there, right? So you got a full-size steam table. You have direct heat. Well, you don't want to put a full-size spillage pan in there because now the whole table's indirect. So what you would do is you would have, let's say, half a pan would be direct heat, and then half a pan or a quarter pan or an eighth pan or a ninth pan or whatever, 1/6 pan, whatever you wanted to use, would have, let's say, chili. You don't want chili on direct heat. You want it in a Bain-Marie style. You want it in a double boiler so that it's never getting direct flames or heat against it. So here's your chili. I'm going to write chili right there. I don't know if you can see it. So you got chili here. But you don't have a pan for it. Your direct heat's coming in, right? This is your direct heat. So what you would do is they make a false bottom pan, and it has perforated holes. So you can put water under it, and then let's say your extra sausages, stuff that you've already cooked, you're holding hot, you could put it there. Chili, on the other case, would be a pan without a false bottom with an insert pan inside of it to hold the chili. And that's how you could do and maintain both indirect and direct heat, which is your boiling, okay, in the same steam table. It's just impossible, though, with the indirect system, okay, without modifying it, cutting this whole built-in bottom out so that these flames can touch the bottom of the pan all the time. Then on the ones you didn't want it to, like your chili, you would use an insert pan to go in here. So I explain that and actually show the pans. I actually show the pans in that thing. It's learnhotdogs.com/bonus. Whoever posted that up, all it says is Facebook user. Thank you, Facebook user. I appreciate that. Oh, look, somebody else posted up the actual full link bonus videos. So either way, thank you for posting that up. It doesn't tell me, for whatever reason, it's not telling me who put that. So, Stever says the Cater Pro has 4 individual burners. And it does, because it has 2 burners per steam table, because it has steam tables that go the other, you know, they go long ways, but they're not built in together. So it's 2 full-size steam tables. The Big Dog has 3 burners, which covers 1 7/8 of a steam table. And that's how big that is. But we set it up so you have direct heat. We give you the pan so you have direct heat. I'm going to put this camera down. So anyway, we put it in with the pan so that you have direct heat, indirect, false bottoms, spillage pan, perforated pans. You get the whole kit and caboodle with it, and that way you're not going, oh my gosh, what do I do? So tomorrow I'll come back with I'll come back with some due diligence stuff, and maybe there'll be a hint of sarcasm and a little bit of me being facetious, because I get so freaking aggravated, because I feel like, man, because this happens even in VU. They join VU, but they don't take advantage of any of the free courses or anything. And then they post up, hey, I just found out I'm going to need a license from the health department. What? Why do you already have a cart? How did you get a cart without doing your due diligence first? So anyway, I'm going to save that till tomorrow when I'm not as pissy about it. Let's see. I'm just looking for questions in the chat. Don't think I'm ignoring you. Classic kettle corn in the house, Brian Pierce. Thanks for being here, Brian. Stever says rant on. it probably shouldn't be today, Stever. Let's see. And keep in mind, if you have questions, there's not stupid questions. Okay, there's not. I'll take your questions, but likelihood, when I see somebody that's had the opportunity, knows that it exists, and then doesn't use it, that aggravates me. So don't be like, well, I'm not going to post my question in the comments because Ben will get mad. No, I won't get mad. I'll answer your question because you may be new and I don't know. You may be brand new, didn't know learnhotdogs.com existed. You didn't know that everything that I sell in courses is free at learnhotdogs.com. Okay? You may have not noticed that there's no ads running across the screen. You know why? Because I am a YouTube partner, okay? But I don't take advantage of the advertising because I hate ads. So, and I talk about my stuff enough, so you kind of get ads either way. You're just not getting a Ford commercial during the middle of this or having to watch 30 seconds of a preview for a movie before you watch the video that you wanted to watch. So, John Mack says, you just joined VU, having trouble getting in. Email support at vendorsunited.com. They'll help you. They're good. Look at there. Facebook user is the Great American Hot Dog Stand because he's awesome. That is Mark Lawler, my dear friend in Alabama. And let's see, just got approved for house. Next stop, a food truck. AJ, do it. Congratulations on the house. That's a good feeling, ain't it? Undercover survivalist. Sorry, I meant to file taxes at the end of the year. If all need help with their ways to fudge the numbers to local. You're asking tax questions, which I ain't good at. I have an accountant and a bookkeeper. The bookkeeper I keep year round, you know, monthly. And then, and it's a nominal fee. It's a small fee. And then at the end of the year, and this is what I suggest you do, they give that to your accountant, all the records. And now it makes your accountant a very inexpensive bill because they don't have to build out the whole books. The books are already built. The accountant knows how to finagle that. So, tax on everything these days. We need a half-size spillage pan manufacturer. There actually is a half-size spillage pan out there, but you can do the same thing with a false bottom. And those are cheaper, $2, $3 with a false bottom, which is just a piece of metal in the bottom or a wire grid in the bottom. Piece of metal in the bottom has holes in it. Look at there. Justin Mack says, track everything in Excel spreadsheet and file monthly taxes in my state. I subtract expenses from revenue to get actual money earned. Perfect, Justin Mack. Do you sell vegan dogs? I've talked about this before, Dave. It's a good question. Not in my area, because there wouldn't be nobody to eat it. But not really, not enough. So there are vendors, like we've got a few vendors in the Oregon area, and they kill it with vegan foods, vegan menus. There's some in the Northeast states that kill it with vegan menus. There's one called Good For You that has been in our group for a long time, and they all their stuff is vegan and or vegetarian and vegan or something, and are healthy for you. Maybe it's healthy for you. So that's what they do. If your market will support that, then go for it. Let's see. My cart has two burners, two small pans on the right, do not have direct heat, but wondering if they would work for cheese and chili. Absolutely. It's indirect heat because you're not getting direct heat from the flame. You're getting indirect heat, which is off to the side. Now, you may still get too hot if you have to jack up your main heat. And, you know, chili and cheese are fun getting out of a pan at the end of the day. Stever says, what do you get when you get, when a cater pro and a concession trailer have a collision? I need to put this up here. I can't even see it. All weather condition, hot dog slamming stand king. Like that, Stever. Thank you. Amanda Easton, congratulations. That is fantastic. Please keep me up to date on how you're progressing. I do have videos and stuff for y'all, more stuff. People been sending me stuff constantly. I'm just behind by days on emails and voicemails. And so I'm trying to get to it all, But some of them, I have to turn around and ask, okay, and then I have to flag the email so that I remember to check back, because I'll ask them, hey, can I share this? So if you're going to share something with me, go ahead and let me know if I can share it. If you're sending a video, if you're asking me something like, hey, Ben, I lost $34 yesterday and I had to throw away six packs of hot dogs. What do I do? Yeah, you don't have to. I wouldn't share that anyway. I'll share your success after you figure out the problem, after I help you figure out the problem. But look at this. Hungry Times hot dogs went out this weekend. It was a success. They want me to set up this Friday and Saturday and Sunday. Holy cow, it's going to be a busy weekend for you. Thomas Lovett, congratulations. Fixing to get my fixed next mount. Hot dog cart store, Ben, I'm going to do an updated walkthrough showing the upgrades I did after your critique video. Thanks. Okay, y'all remember the video I put out a week or two ago? And I talked about some things he needed to do. This is Art, and he's going to give us a new video with the updates and let us know how things are going. Because we're not here to go, hey, you're stupid. That's stupid. No, we're not here to do that. We're here to help each other. And it's why I always tell people to go to Vendors United. Try it out. Check it out. Go see if it's for you. If you're going to get into this business, get into it right. Okay, make the enormous investment of $27 and stay in it. But the first 5 days, I'll give you absolutely free and not kind of minimal access. I'll give you 100% access. So grab the free stuff, get all that stuff, and you can leave. Okay, but if you stay, it's $27, $27 freaking dollars to take your business from having all learning curves to going just maddening good. And we've got vendors in there right now that are killing it. Luis Martinez, my buddy and my brother from another mother out in Texas. Texas Squeezer Lemonade and Catering is in the house. I've shared some of his videos, and he shares a lot and over in VU too. He's always on our VU Mastermind. That's a private meeting we do every week, okay? How hard would it be to add a funnel fryer to a hot dog cart if customized? You can actually do it. We've got some vendors that have done that, and I believe there's one still doing it in North Carolina from the hot dog cart. They're using a direct heat pan, stainless steel pan, not an aluminum one. Aluminum one will work, but aluminum pans, if you run out of the fluid that keeps it from burning through, you'll burn your pan in half. So it's better to use a stainless steel pan, but you can put the grease right in the stainless steel pan, and you don't have to put much grease in there to do funnel cakes. You could use a grill on the side of the cart with a cast iron skillet. You could use, those are perfect. And we've got vendors that have done that at fairs and festivals, right from the skillet. $7.50 for a fruit covered, I did a video about it. He did a fruit covered, preserves. He put preserves and powdered sugar on funnel cakes. Let's see, with the big dog cart, I added pulled turkey barbecue last Friday at a subdivision. I did it, sold out, full third size pan, 6-inch deep. Some people wanted it on their nachos, and I obliged with a small fee. I don't blame you, Justin Mack, that's smart. Let's see, Gary says, I went out Friday. I love this when I see all this positive stuff. Profit was great. I used a Blackstone griddle to help my pans keep up temp, working great. That's fantastic. It's fantastic. I got a vendor that did the their whole setup with a Blackstone and with lemon smashers, the manual smashers. Right now, lemonade vendors are killing it. Okay, and let me tell you what they're doing, because it's an easy way to get in, and I teach it. Go to how to start a lemonade business. Don't buy any fancy machines. Just follow my instructions there. It's what I told my adult sisters 2 years ago. Okay. And they did it, and they made over $500 their first night, okay? So go, they did something, it was called something on the green, it was at nighttime. If you go over there, you can start lemonade for less than $500, $400, okay? And you can make that back the first day. So let it buy your hot dog cart, let it buy your next, don't go out and buy a new car with the money. Go invest in yourself, invest in your business, invest in your knowledge, and keep going. And let that first lemonade smasher that handheld, press it down, squeezer, smisher, smasher, thingamabob, let it make you the money, okay? You don't have to have anything fancy to get it all done. And so go to howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. It's a website I created just to help you start a lemonade business. And I've helped family members, I've helped friends, close friends, dear friends, and I've helped thousands of vendors do it over the years. And it works every single time. It works. Some states have a little red tape, some don't. Some states, it's really easy because it's agriculture and then you don't need a license or nothing. But do that. Look at that. Gary Stevens says, did lemonade and hot dogs. With the big dog card, I had to pull. Okay, I read that one. Then understand again. I'm sorry. Stanley, I do wish you the best. Okay, would it be possible to sell snow cones ice cream? And let me tell you, I would never do that without a food truck or a food trailer, something that had a generator on it to keep everything cold. I've tried it. I even got other vendors to try it because while I'm trying it, I'm sharing it in our group. So a lot of other vendors started doing the dry ice method and these real expensive coolers that keep stuff cold. They're actually seafood coolers. And so we were doing this, and it is hard to make money with that in a broad area. So you got to fish in a small pond with ice cream and stuff. It is good, and there's vendors who make a killing with ice cream trucks and stuff. But as far as adding it as a treat on your cart, if you go back to some of our archives at learnhotdogs.com, you'll see when I did it. You'll see when I had two carts doing it. And then you'll see Jason Brown was doing it with me. He was even doing the Vienna had come out with ice creams, cheesecakes on a stick and stuff. And he was doing it. We all were doing it. Or I say all, a lot of us were doing it and reporting our numbers. And it's pretty much sucked. You know, there's places that ice cream does great. But hot dogs do great about everywhere. And lemonade does great about everywhere. So ice cream just not always the hit if you just showed up with ice cream. Let's see. I just bought a cart that is full pan direct heat that is removable as the rest is Bain-Marie style double boiler set up on the side. I could put third size pans. Question is, when you boil your dogs, can you boil the regular dogs and brats in the same water? You can, unless you got some kind of crazy brat that is like maple bacon, you know, honey brats or cayenne jalapeno brats. You don't want to put those with your hot dogs because somebody may go, what are you doing? Why do these hot dogs taste funny? I would separate it, but you don't have to. If I was going to have to put them because of limited space and stuff, I would use more of a standard standalone brat or sausage that was not so powerful that its flavors leached out onto my dogs and created a weird tasting dog. There, look at there. Stever says, VU is a tax write-off. It's free, people. It's 100% tax write-off. It's not like, oh my gosh. No, you're investing in yourself. If you right now you go out and you take a training course and you want to become a roofer and you go to a school or a class or you buy courses online, that's all write-off. That's all a write-off, 100% write-off, not a portion, all of it. Same with VU. You buy one of my courses, you buy my Hot Dog Save My Life book, and you start vending, you can write it all off. You can write off VU, you can write it all off. Lewis says, we're killing it. See what I'm telling y'all? If you have an inclination or a desire to do this business, join VU. If you're already doing it and maybe you're not getting the results you want, join VU. Go to vendorsunited.com. Sign up for the 5-day trial. Okay? It's free. And try it. And get to meet Lewis and Stever and Mark Lawler. And you'll go, oh, man. I see what you're talking about. Rebel says, soon to be a vendor here. Thank you for the videos. You're absolutely welcome. Keep me up to date on your progress. I think that's awesome. Joe's in the house. He says he's all ears. Good to see you, Joe. Brian. See, Brian's a smart vendor too. Brian was the one just posted up a little bit ago. Yes, lemonade. Don't scrimp on the ingredients. Absolutely. Do it right. I show you how to do it. Okay. And I learned from one of the best. So go do it right. So I've even updated my knowledge because of one of the vendors in the VU group, Ken Packer. Okay. The guy is a master at this stuff with lemonade. Let's see. Thank you, Lewis, for those kind words. Rebel, how they're doing ice cream from a cart is one of those seafood coolers, dry ice, and selling ice cream. You'll get a lot of loss, okay? Because the more times you open that cooler, the more times heat goes in that cooler, and your cool goes out the cooler, and pretty soon you got ice cream puddles. I tried all kinds of things making that work. I had a solar canopy on my cart, okay? I have pictures, and I filmed this stuff. This has been several years back. And I had the solar deal that went down to a battery bank that ran the AC/DC LP gas, even refrigerator freezer deal. And still it's a nightmare. It's a nightmare. I would only do it if I had a trailer, a food trailer or food truck. And before y'all go out and buy a food trailer or food truck, the best way to get your feet wet in this business, and you'll probably find out you'll make more money, is get you a hot dog cart. And you'll go, oh, it's not just a hot dog cart. It's a mini mobile kitchen, which means you can cater. You can do all kinds of cool stuff. So it's not just exclusive to hot dogs. We just all call it a hot dog cart. Justin Mack, I agree, the cheesecake. Justin Mack, that's good advice there. Y'all see that? He says, your cart monthly payment is tax break, and there's a tax code for it. Oh, look here, Keith G in the house. That's another one in VU that you should be following because you just learn. Every time you get around these people and they're sharing their stuff daily on the page and you go, oh my gosh, I didn't know that I could make this much. Well, mini donuts. He's got a food truck called Totally Fried, and that has fried everything. And there's just so much value in coming into VU that you go, it's almost overwhelming. But just pick the thing that you want to do. And I'd suggest everybody, if you're starting out with very little to no money, start out with freaking lemonade and go from there. Let lemonade buy your Maserati later, okay? And build up your business from there. We have vendors in there now who started just weeks ago in lemonade who have ordered a cart from me already. They've already earned the money to buy a cart. And that's just weeks. That tells you can do this over and over. All you do is follow some simple steps. Just follow it, go through the red tape, whatever red tape there is, which I show you, and then get it done. And then the red tape's over. And you don't have to look back at that. You just move on. Look there. He's set up at a shopping center with Family Dollar two to 3 days a week for lunch only. Yeah, most vendors do lunch only. It's usually about 11 to 1, 11 to 2, and that's it. Let's see. Yep, Keith, I'm excited too. Every Monday night we do a live VU, Vendors United Mastermind group, and there's new people and old people like Keith, real old people like Keith, who come on and we share and we take questions and we help each other get better and we all learn something and we it gives us the juice to make more money this week than we did last week. I'd like to invite you over. If you joined right now, you wouldn't be able to get into tonight's probably, because every time I do that right before a show, they never get them all in, because it's a process to get in. Let's see. I have a cash cow with one full steam pan. What can I put on top of the cart from getting so hot? Turn down your heat, number one, okay, and you can divide that. you know, the cash cow, depending on which one you have, as far as which steam table you have, you can split it up. So if you got a two burner one or a three burner, if you have the bigger steam table. So it's just like a big dog, which I'll walk you through at learnhotdogs.com/bonus. The, all carts get hot. It's an oven. Okay. The better your burners are, the hotter it can get. We are the only manufacturer that does a triple insulation deal, but still it gets hot. I'm telling you, ask any vendor. They get hot. Carts get hot. Unless you have one of these cheesy little Bain-Marie things that have a 3,000 BTU one burner system under it that's like putting a candlelight under it at a catering event or something, and it just kind of keeps it lukewarm. Those exist out there. Those don't get real hot. So, in fact, they don't get hot at all. The sun will heat up the top of the cart more than the stove. Let's see. Where can you rent a cart? I teach that, over in learnhotdogs.com/broke. Go there and you'll see how I teach to go through Craigslist and Facebook Marketplace and to put out feelers, and you can find vendors. Cause a lot of people go, Ben, I live in Atlanta, Georgia, and I ain't ever seen a vendor. Well, there's a lot of vendors in Atlanta, Georgia, and you ain't seeing them because you don't know where they are. That they ain't usually at Fifth and Main, okay? Most successful vendors have figured out some key spots, and some of those aren't in the hubbub of town. And then some vendors are, like Michael Wood. He's in the hubbub of town of four people, though. But he's there, and that's a vendor that's doing – he doesn't work anymore, and he's making double to triple what he used to make. Because more people are coming to vendors right now instead of restaurants. So, look at that. Art says, I actually set up at 8 a.m. and sell breakfast sausages and usually start getting customers for hot dogs and brats by 10. I packed up and leave at 3. That's fantastic. I saw today Daddy-O's was doing serving, it looked like French toast and bacon breakfast. That's up my alley right there. The website for how to start a lemonade business is howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. Howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. I'd love it if somebody posted that in a chat on YouTube, if you're listening on YouTube. I think that was YouTube. Nope, that was Facebook. I don't know where. It was a Facebook. So howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. Let's see. That's awesome. Anyway, I got to go. I got to get caught up eventually with emails, and I'm not going to do that by being here. I love you. I hope that this helps clear up some of that information, and hopefully I stop some of you from buying a cart maybe that has that indirect heat where you can't change it. You always want to be able to see the burners. Look down the hole and see the burners. If you can't see the burners, you have an indirect closed system, okay? Unless that pan comes out and then you can see the burners, but then you'd be able to see the burners and then it wouldn't be an indirect heat. So, I'll see y'all tonight, the ones that'll be there. I love you. Talk to you soon. Bye.